हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज द टॉपिक एज इलेक्ट्रोकार्डियोग्राम। इलेक्ट्रोकार्डियोग्राम इज ऑल्सो रेफर्ड एज ईसीजी, विच इज यूज टू फाइंड आउट द माल फंक्शनिंग ऑफ द हार्ट। एंड देयरफॉर हियर इज द टॉपिक इलेक्ट्रोकार्डियोग्राम, द डिवाइस, द इंस्ट्रूमेंट for the first time, the technique, how to use this device was given by Antonin. Antonin is called as father of electrocardiography. So let us discuss what actually is the electrocardiogram, what do you mean by electrocardiograph. Actually, this instrument is used to find out the abnormalities or otherwise the malfunctioning of the heart. So what is done with the patient is, the patient is admitted in the hospital with empty stomach. The instrument as electrocardiogram consists of a monitor which is associated with the electricity, electric current is passed through which the electric current which is passed is a very less in the terms of millivolts, whereas it also consists of the electrodes. The sophisticated electrocardiogram, the instrument consists of 16 electrodes. The 16 electrodes actually are made up of from the metal as cadmium, where out of 16, two of the electrodes are located on the chest, the two are on the arms, the remaining are at various regions of the body on the legs, and therefore here to the skin the gel is applied and on the gel the electrodes are stuck. They are located because it requires a material medium to pass the waves, and therefore let us see how come this electrocardiogram is used. Before that, the definition of electrocardiogram is a graphic record of electrical potential generated by the heart during one heartbeat or one cardiac cycle is called as electrocardiogram. Then what should be electrocardiograph? It is an action potential generated by the heart muscles. It is an action potential generated by heart muscles to record the impulses is called as electrocardiography. So here is, when the patient is admitted, this device, as the electrodes are connected, are located at different positions of the body, the mild electric current is passed which shows the functioning of heart as the events which are associated with one heartbeat are recorded on the electrocardiograph. Actually, this graph can be produced as a printout or otherwise it is observed, it is studied online, and therefore when it is given in the form of a printout, that can be stored, can be shown to the physician, will observe the various abnormalities or the functions of the heart. And here, this is the diagram to show one heartbeat is observed, is shown in the graphical record, in which x-axis determines the seconds that is time is in seconds, and on y axis it is the current which is passed as in millivolts. So this millivolt current is passed and this graphical record is given, out of which at the center you can see the line is called as a baseline. Above the baseline the wave is a positive wave, below the baseline the wave is a negative wave, and here one heartbeat is represented as one cardiac cycle is completed within a period of 0.8 seconds. So here are these three main waves which are given in the form of P wave, QRS wave and P wave. What actually are these three waves? You can see the first wave is a very small deflection which is observed as P wave, is given a sharp triangle as the second, and the inflated the third wave as the T wave. So what does these waves represent? So here is the P wave is a small upward wave representing impulse generated by SA node. Where is this SA node situated? In the right atrium. So this SA node is the initiation of conduction of wave, where SA node conducts this wave of contraction from right atrium to left atrium, and here it causes atrial depolarization. Atrial depolarization is nothing but it is also called as it causes atrial, yes, systole. Atrial systole remains for the period of how much time? 0.1 second. During this 1 second, what happens is, yes, the blood from the respective atria, it enters into the respective ventricles. Is that clear? So this wave is referred as P wave. A very small deflection you can see here. Whereas the second wave is a QRS wave, is a sharp triangle, where this sharp triangle represents, in this triangle R is the point which is on the upper side which shows a positive wave, whereas towards the lower side are the points as Q and S, they are at the negative. So it is called as negative wave, out of which P, R and T are positive and QS is a negative. Well, now what is QRS wave? It is a downward deflection. Is a downward deflection continuous as a large upright triangular wave. A large, see from here, from P it came towards the lower side, again went in the upright position, formed a sharp triangle. So here a large upright triangular wave ends as a downward wave. See here, ends as a downward wave. It represents the spreading of impulse from, yes, from SA node to AV node. From AV node it is conducted towards the bundle of His, and from bundle of His to Purkinje's fibers, which shows ventricular depolarization. What does it show? Ventricular depolarization, which remains for the period of 0.3 seconds. During this what happens? Ventricles undergo ventricular systole, that is ventricle undergo contraction, and during ventricles when we undergo contraction, what happens? The blood from the respective ventricles will enter into the blood vessels as aorta and pulmonary trunk. How much time does it take? It takes 0.3 seconds. So the QRS, the wave is completed within a period of 0.3 3 seconds. Then the third wave is the wave as a TV. Are these two waves similar, P and T? No. You can see the difference as it is the short, a very small deflection. And here you will see the inflated, the deflection is. Where it is the wave, a broad upward wave which represents the ventricular repolarization. Both of these are depolarizations. And here what happens with the ventricle? Ventricle undergoes the process of repolarization, means it undergoes the process of, here ventricles will undergo relaxation. Relaxation is diastole. So how much time does it take? 0.4 seconds. During this 0.4 seconds, what will happen? Yes, now the bicuspid and tricuspid walls will get closed because it should prevent the backflow. And the blood which entered into the blood vessels will be transported. But now the atrias will get empty. So those atrias should get filled with the respective stream of blood. So here it shows the normal ECG of a normal patient. If the patient consists of this normal ECG, the heart is functioning well. There are no abnormalities. And here, this is used to find out actually where the abnormalities are. Is there anything wrong in SA node as a pacemaker? Is there something wrong in AV node as a setter, as a pace setter? Or otherwise, what is the condition of the heart muscles as cardiac muscles, as a nodal tissue? So that can be studied with the help of a device, with the help of a machinery that is called as electrocardiogram. Is that clear? So here, I want you all to study what actually is the depolarization and what do you mean by the repolarization. Actually, it is the process of, here it may be the inward and the outward movement of some ions from the region of lower concentration to the region of higher concentration. So that will make you to understand. So I want all of you to see, to study what actually is the term depolarization, what we mean by repolarization. So these two terms, once again we are going to discuss in nervous coordination. So before that, try to find it out. If you are getting it, it is well and good. If not, I'll explain you. But till that time, this will be a homework. You will find it out as what is depolarization and what do you mean by repolarization. Definitions as both. It's okay? All of you understood?